check out the main traveler. So, Inazuma will come 1.7. The main traveler gets Electrovision. One Electrovision for the traveler. So we have right now Animal and Geo. Inazuma will be Electro, and now we're gonna check out the abilities, the things you need to level him up and stuff like that. His rarity is like 5-star. I don't know why. Maybe he will be OP in the future, but that's just foreshadowing. His weapon type is the typical one-handed sword. He's the normal sword attack, like he does a double strike when you hold, and the normal strikes when you just press or spam left click, yeah. So what does he forget of a traveler? He has a special stat like every other character. Maybe you get elemental mastery, crit rate and stuff on the other characters, but for Aether we get some decent attack percent. It's decent, nothing that great. But yeah, just normal. Like the main character should be. The sentient material you should already have. It's something you get from Adventure Rank, I think, and from the Animal Sigils and Geo Sigils. You can farm throughout the entire world in Teyvat here. These flowers, just use the Genshin Impact interactive map, which also applies to the Hilliard mask. Just also use the Genshin Impact interactive map to get better routes, to improve your daily stuff. If you get bored with a game, don't overdo it. You want to play it, I know. Yeah, we are currently in a dry zone right now with Genshin, but my current event is fun, and yeah, let's don't waste anyone's time, just go to the next thing. I already talked about this, the tech talent, just standard stuff, you can skip that. Now we get to Lightning Blade. It's like the KIE. If you don't know what a KIE is, he thrusts forward with his sword and creates like the ice spears. And this thing will be just three electro orbs you can push forward. This will penetrate the enemy and will leave behind amulets. These things can be collected by other characters, and we're gonna get there when we get to the talents. When you're absorbing, we get elemental energy and increase the energy recharge. That's great, decent. It has sadly a CD of 13.5 seconds, but constellation, or is it the talent, will change a bit. We're gonna check that out. The energy regeneration will bump up to 4 particles, so it's okay. Are these electro particles or are these ordinary particles? Would be insane if they are ordinary ones, when the traveler would be one of the best supports, I think. Yeah, that's pretty good stuff right here. Duration is 6 seconds. So, and the ambulance amulet, the things that are left behind when you hit the enemy, may hold for 15 seconds. So now we're gonna go get to the ultimate. So the ultimate is like, again, Chaos One, I think. Instead of rotating around you, they're just stationary, but still follow you around. The lightning shot. When you activate characters, normals, or charge attack, hit opponents with falling thunder forth. Okay. This falling thunder forth, the falling thunder, which can be generated every 0.5 seconds. That sounds interesting with this damage scaling. We should check out that in the future, yeah. The good thing about this is it's a constant proc. You always get it. It has a duration of 12 seconds. You get it after 8 seconds that. It's insane. You just need to keep up your energy recharge, and yeah, this might be a really strong ability. The talents are Interesting. Well, the traveler, we get many different books. Like, you need to farm all these books from different dungeons. It's quite a bit annoying. But we need to get through it. And the normal scrolls. These are Hilch's scrolls from the mages, I think. Not the Abyss Mage, but the standard mages who carry around a staff, like, yeah. This is something that Dvalin drops. Just get lucky. You may be already have some of these. And a crown. You shouldn't crown the main character. Yeah, so obviously, so many characters, which are much more, much better. Not Ember, though. Rip Ember mains. So, now we get to the passive talents. When another nearby character in the party obtains an Abundance Amulet created by Lightning Blade, and Lightning Blade's CD will be decreased by 1.5 seconds. That's good. That's the cooldown problem EFAS of his E ability will be solved by this. No, it won't be just completely solved, but it will be a bit better. Yeah, decent. That's just how MC should be. Decent. Now we're gonna go to the next talent. Increase the energy recharge effects granted by Lightning Blade Impudence Amulet by 10% of a traveler's energy recharge. So, it will just be increased. Standard stuff by 10%. That's decent. Again, MC stuff. Now we're gonna get to the constellations. You will get all of these, like for free, or for some sigils, I think, yeah. And we're gonna go through each one. So, we have the Spring Harvest Thunder. The number of Ambulance Amulets can be generated using, that can be generated using Lightning Blade is increased to 3. So, you have 3 Lightning Blades that you use to thrust, and 3 of Impudence Amulets will spawn near the enemy. That's good. That means there's also more cooldown reduction, because you take another character, get the Impudence, you profit from your talent, from this talent, Thunder Flash. So, Violet Vehemence. When Falling Thunder created by Billowing Thunder hits an opponent, it will decrease the Electro Rest by 15% for 8 seconds. Another one, which is decent. Nothing too great, but decent. 15%. Not that much, but for a C2? Yeah. MC. Now we're going to go to Distant Crackling. The increase of a level. Increases the level of Bellowing Thunder by 3. Standard stuff like any character. And Fickle Cloud Strike. When a character obtains a Abundance Amulet generated by Lightning Blade, if this character energy is less than 35%, the energy restored by the Abundance Amulet increases to 100%. That's pretty good. Especially if you lose like a Noelle backup. Or you heal and stuff, and she just used up ult. You go to Aoife or Lumine, the traveler, use your stuff, and then you go to Noelle again, take that stuff, and you get much more energy. It's pretty good. So these things are okay. I'm gonna talk about it when we are done with the constellation. So increases the level by 3 of Lightning Blade. Yeah, standard stuff. Okay, now it gets interesting. World Shaker. Every 2 Falling Thunder attacks triggered by Billowing Thunder will increase the damage dealt by the next Falling Thunder by 100% and will restore an additional 1 energy to the current character. This thing. This changes the kit drastically. Now it has more energy recharge, more damage. And Aoife, Lumine, the Traveler. Why I don't just say the Traveler, man? I'm gonna make it so hard for me. No? If you have all the constellations with Electro, you will be, in my opinion, one of the best energy recharge supports. I don't know any other character which just generates so much energy for your team. These are probably normal particles. It's insane. They give you more than, for example, you get plus 20. You get some free particles out of it, but these are wind particles. And if you have Hu Tao, want to get those particles, you change Hu Tao. You don't get much of it. Neutral particles. The game completely changes. If these are just electro particles, it would still be insanely decent. I'm above average. That's actually it. Aoife, the next, follow me, traveler. Next character for Inazuma, which has a electro vision. Don't forget that it gets a buff, mini electro vision itself, so catching mains, official mains, and all electro users will benefit from it pretty well. And probably Traveler will be one of the more decent ones and will be more used often. That's what I wanna see. Just wanna see the main character in the cutscenes and stuff, but yeah, this is something that which I like. I always like to play the main character, but the abilities really did fall off in endgame, so it just changed to the insanely legendary characters which I got from the banners and stuff, like you did. You got your D-Luke, like your Jean and stuff. These are just much better characters instead of Aoife, but the new Aoife, Traveler Lumine, whatever. Traveler, why? sorry. Can be a good part of your team, even in Abyss. That's actually it. Thanks for watching. Leave a like and subscribe. I'm just starting out with YouTube thing. And it's fun. And see you next time. Bye bye.